Next, the latest addition to our NewsHour bookshelf. Lab Girl by geobiologist Hope Jahren is both an investigation of the thrilling lives of plants and a deeply personal memoir. Jeffrey Brown has that.
Hope Jahren, welcome to you.
Thank you.
So part memoir, part science, what were you after? Or are they both the same to you?
Yes, well, I wanted to write a book, and in my field, that's what you do. You get your degree, and you write a lot of papers, and you get a broad view of the field, and you write a textbook, which changes
for other scientists.
Yeah, which changes the way it's taught, and the field goes forward. When I sat down to do that, I couldn't keep my own story out of it. When I really tried to explain what we'd accomplished, I needed to talk about how we accomplished it, and then I needed to talk about all the late nights and special people and strange experiences that went into that. I couldn't keep the two separate, so now you've got a book where it's all entwined.
So it begins for your first discovering, or at least seeing science, in your father's lab.
Yes.
He taught science at community college, right?
Yes.
What did you see?
My various early memories as a small child were in the laboratory. You know, what it smelled like, what the cement felt like, the hard angles of it, the shiny objects and the interesting things and how they could all be used for something. And they were toys, but they weren't toys. They were serious things.
Yeah, you even write, there's nothing in the world more perfect than a slide rule.
Yes, yes.
That's a serious thing. Huh?
Yes, exactly. It's a beautiful thing that we don't use anymore, unfortunately. But we broke things and then we fixed them. You know, you could have fun breaking them, you could have fun fixing them. There was nowhere better.
It's the natural world, though, the plant world of plant life that ultimately grabbed you.
Yes.
Why?
It's the biggest question there is. What does it mean to be alive on the planet? And answering that for you and me is one thing, but answering it for an organism that's so terribly different than we are and so terribly much more successful and long-lived and spectacular that we can't even interview the way you can ask me a question. I have to pull it out of its environment and put it in the lab and try to grow it and control it and work so hard to just get a small window into something so different.
You know, I was thinking, because so much of your book is about moving through the world and seeing green, right?
Yeah,
seeing colors around us. And yet most of us, maybe I should speak for myself, we don't see it every day.
Yes.
It's right there, but we don't see it.
But you used to. You got away from that. I think another thing I say in the book is that everybody has a tree they remember from being a child. It's very common I meet somebody who remembers looking carefully at a tree and being near it and what it meant to them, etc. And I think one of the only interesting things about me is that I never lost that. I never moved away from it.
One of the interesting things about the way you write the book, going back and forth between yourself and the plant world, is the similarities, but also, as you were saying just before, the great differences between us, right?
Yes, it's juxtaposed.
Yeah.
I talk a little bit about how a plant establishes itself and the struggles it undergoes. And I talk a little bit about how I established myself and the good parts and the bad parts and the tough parts. And then I let the reader say to themselves, did I see any similar threads? Did I see any differences? And it's turned out to be a wonderful thing to see people read it. Has been wonderful.
Some of the tough parts, personal parts, about your struggles with depression, bipolar disorder.
Yeah.
You had to work hard to keep this under management, right? But it affected your life tremendously.
Yeah, yeah. I spent 10 years being very sick and hiding it. I spent 10 years doing the very hard work of getting well. And I had not seen that written in a book the way it had been a real thing for me for very important parts of my life. And so I thought, maybe I can do this. Maybe I can make a book that tackles this in a way it hasn't been done before. And I did my best.
And then, of course, I mean, for all the wonder of scientific discovery and research, there's the nuts and bolts of, you know, actually being a worker, right?
Absolutely.
Of having to get funding, of having to get positions to teach and do your research.
Absolutely. Yeah. It's work. I mean, it's hard work that doesn't usually pay off. It's hard and it might not come to anything. And the only salvation you have is the joy you get from the moment, the joy that you get from watching the samples accumulate right next to you.
It's called Lab Girl.
Yes.
You are a woman in science, right?
Yes.
You write about this, all the discussion about why there aren't more women. Is it sexism at a individual level, at a cultural level? What do you see going on?
Well, I think being a scientist is a position of respect and power and access, and it's a privileged position in society. And I think there are fundamental mechanisms that keep men and women from achieving the same level of power and access and privilege in society. And so I think these things apply to science in the same way that they apply in who's, you know, in Congress and who's running the world in many other ways.
But give me an example. I mean, where does it happen? Because in this discussion, there's always, what happens to young girls who start out interested and somehow don't make the same progress or don't achieve the same positions?
One thing that was very important to me was that I felt comfortable in the lab from being very, very small. I knew that that's where I belonged and I could fix things and move things, and no matter how many classrooms I went into where I was the only girl in the physics class or whatever, I never questioned the fact that I didn't belong there. I knew that as well as I knew my own name, that this was the place where I was comfortable and this is the place where I could do things.
All right. The book is Lab Girl, Hope Jahren. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.